Good evening. Chances are you have not heard a piece for oboe and string quartet, which is a shame because, as you'll hear, it works quite well. Actually, in the beginning of the 20th century, there was a sudden increase in writing for oboe and strings, and this is due mainly because there was a famous oboist at the time named Leon Goossens, and so many pieces were written for him. And his virtuosity and talent attracted not only composers, but also an arts patron named Elizabeth Sprague Coolidge. So she commissioned this piece for him, and it just so happens that she also financed this hall we are in right now. So that's pretty cool. The Bliss Quintet is heavily influenced by folk song, which is very noticeable. And in fact, in the third movement, he includes an Irish fiddle song called Connolly's Jig in its entirety, and it's heard in every voice except for the first violin, but he gets plenty of high notes, so it sort of makes up for it. But let's have an example from our violist. So the piece is mainly in 6/8, but it has quick meter changes that you'll barely even notice, and it happens quite a bit. So just like the jig in 6/8, you'll hear it throughout. So we really enjoyed playing this piece, and actually we kind of got our inspiration for our group name from it. Release That Dove is what we're called, and that's because after a very ethereal second movement, we come to this lively third movement that's kind of like a dance, but then on the last note, we have an upward bow that just almost calls for an upward hand gesture, like you're releasing a dove into the air. So that's kind of our inside joke, and it just kind of goes to show that we had a lot of fun with it, and I think you will too.